Hello and welcome to this rough review of this Brinckers Brooklyn F7 bicycle. It's an electric bicycle and it's several years old. This is a rough review. It's a one cut with some jump cuts in between. And the advantage is, I will tell you my honest opinion based on long time usage. The disadvantage is, it's a bit rough in it. I don't have much time for editing, so we'll jump right to it. First, I will give you a spoiler. I would not have bought this bike if I knew what I know today, and I will tell you why in the end. One of the things I noticed when my girlfriend bought an e-bike was that when she put the key in her battery, like this, and started it, then she couldn't take the key out. And you see a lot of people driving with their keys like that. Personally, I think that's crazy. I would never do that, so I made sure I can take the key out when I have unlocked the battery. It's the same thing with the bike lock. The bike lock that came on this bicycle actually had that very nasty feature, and I managed to throw one key away in the 14 days that I had that nasty lock. So I will always make sure when the lock is unlocked, then you should be able to take out your key. Another thing about this specific bike is the backlight, the tail light. When I turn it on, I have a nice legal tail light. Nothing to say about that. Usually on electric bikes, it will turn on when you switch on the key, because you have this nice big battery with a lot of electricity. And why not use it for this little LED light? The people who made these bikes think no. So you have to disassemble this backlight. It's almost as difficult as changing the screen on a smartphone to do that, to replace two AA batteries. And with a normal usage, you have to do that at least two or three times a year. Why? You have this nice big battery. There was even a hole from the bike. Hello, cat. There was even a hole from the place where the light is sitting and into the battery compartment. You just had to pull the wires and add some components that pretty much every electric bike does. But no, they had to choose this solution. Avoid that. That's just annoying. When it comes to the front light, they actually had the courtesy of hooking it up to the battery. The problem is that this little cable, you can not see it on a distance, maybe I will cut to it, is just a little bit too short. So when you turn the handle too much a few times, then it will fall out and you had to put it on. And actually, in the end, you never know when your light is turned on, because it just might be falling out. And my girlfriend's other branded bike had the same problem. So try to turn the handle, see if the cable is stretched a bit too much. This bicycle is what I will call an old women's bicycle. It has some dampers here. That means there is a limited amount of baskets you can get to it. It also had this handbrake with some spring in it that made that even you pushed very hard, it would not stop too much. I had it replaced for a normal one. I don't know what this piece is called, but on the original bike you could unlock it to swing the handlebar up and down. Nice feature, but it wasn't very strong, so I ended up getting a strong part here. At some point, and I think that's my own fault, I like the tires called Schwalbe Marathon Plus, because they are some of the best and puncture resistant tires. I saw there was some new ones called Trek instead of Plus. They are just as puncture resistant, but they take up a little more room, they have more grip. They are half mountain bike, half normal tires. The problem is that I don't know what these are called. The place where they are attached to the bike, both front and back, got broken, so I actually had to zip tie them together, and it works, but I would just have kept my Schwalbe Marathon Plus on the bicycle. This bicycle has a very annoying software bug. When you can set the electric power, it gives from 0 to 9, where 9 is the fastest, and it actually pulls really well at 9. The problem is, if I go have it on 9 and only power level 9, and I go something like 26, 27, maybe a little more, then suddenly power level 9 will cut completely out. It will not help me at all. Then I can go down to power level 8, and it will help me just fine, but only at level 8. And then I go up to 9, no, will not help me. I don't see why. If the battery was overheating, then level 8 should do the same thing. I had tried to contact the manufacturer. They could not find out anything. There's no software update for the bike. Brinckers just sent me to the manufacturer. Once you have bought the bike, they don't want to touch you at all. All in all, I would say it's actually a pretty nice bike. I could even fit this holder for children's seat back here. Usually, you will have to get a special holder that sits on here. So that was very nice. Instead of a normal Danish luggage carrier, that's one where you can sweep it up, I think it's this way, and then there's a spring holding everything down. They just have this one without any mechanics, and these two holders for an elastic band. That elastic band was very bad. I would say just throw it out just when you get the bike. I didn't throw it out. I had it on my bike, so what one day it was caught in the wheel, and it took a lot of time to get it out. Just throw that out away once you get it, if you have that. But all in all, it's actually one annoying thing. When you change the gear, it's this standard Shimano 7-speed. You have to turn it like this. A lot of bikes have that, and once I loved it, but the problem is when it's a rainy day, it can be very hard to turn it, and sometimes I cannot turn it at all when it is raining. So I love the clicky gears when you cannot change them fast, but you can change them when it's wet outside. It has this nice little cute bike though. A lot of people don't hear it, but you can just get a better one for pretty much no money if you want to do that. But I will say it's a very, very nice bike. It pulls a lot. You might be able to see that I have this attachment for this Burley children's carrier. I have another review several years old of that. It pulls it just fine. In power level 9, it really pulls a lot, and some people might think that's too much. I think it's nice, and it's possible to raise the maximum speed a little bit if you search the internet for some hints. Problems with this bike: I had a lot of battery problems. I think within the first month, the first battery just died completely. Then I got a new one. How did that die? Yeah, for some reason when it charged, it would show it was the battery was fully charged, or at least not charging anymore. And then at some point a long time after that, it would start charge again. So the charger might indicate that the battery was full, but it was not full at all. So I got a new one. There was some problems with some screws, so the battery pretty much fell apart. So I got a new one. It had those other problems, and yeah, the same problem with charging. So then I got this one that actually had the same ones, but they said keep the battery. And I thought, okay, I don't want to do this anymore. I have two batteries that are working okay as long as I charge them overnight. And that has worked okay. So I basically got a very expensive battery for free. When I see somebody buying an electric bike, I always say to them, buy the biggest battery from the start, because not only you can go longer when the battery gets worn, then you can use it a little bit more. So you usually can ride 10 kilometers on a battery, Then with, if you have the, then at some point you can only go 9 or 7 or 6, then you can stretch that a bit longer with a bigger battery. But all in all, it has actually been a pretty okay bike. Not too much have to be repaired. I am on my first chain. It's the first time for a long time I have internal gears. I usually have the external ones where everything have to be changed once a year. I live in Denmark where we have snows, and to fight that, the ice on the roads, they put salt on the roads, and that just kills external gears. So after every winter, I use it. I have not had a problem with that. But there is one reason I will say I would never buy this bike again. Actually, I cannot do that right now, because it was only one company in Denmark who sold this bike. It was called Hello Rider at the time when I bought it. And then they went bankrupt. And what happened there, because all this is Brinckers specific, I cannot buy a new battery. I cannot get the bike replaced. My colleague actually had a bike that completely died. They had to drive for an hour, that's a long time in Denmark, from a very big city to a small city, where they found a place that could spend a lot of time fixing it. A lot of the bike repair shops said, we cannot get parts for Brinckers, we have not been educated in that. Others said, yeah, we can try, but it will be very expensive, and our customers usually get angry when we try doing something we is not certified in doing, so no, we will not do that. And the Brinckers just say, yeah, you have bought the bike, not our problem. So the problem is that Brinckers only sold it through one company in Denmark, and when that went belly up, they did not do anything else. I might have to drive to Germany to get this thing repaired if it breaks. I don't have a car, so I will probably not spend several days getting a bike repaired. That's just stupid. Some people might be able to do it themselves. I don't know. Fortunately, I don't have that problem now. But the problem with electric bikes is that they are usually the only place you can get them repaired is at the shops who are certified in the specific brand. And there only was one for Brinckers. Many of the bikes use standard systems like Bosch, and that means you can pretty much get them repaired everywhere. So the next time I buy an electric bike, I will do it from the local dealership. I would say always go local, stupid thing of me, and also get a brand that everybody can repair. That being said, I'm actually happy for this bike as long as it works, and I just cross my fingers that it will keep doing that. Thank you.